You ready to go? It is the GOAT, the greatest of all time, the greatest off-roader of all time, the Ford Bronco! Alright, now that I've got your attention, we need to talk seriously. I have been in the process of buying the new Ford Bronco, and obviously as you see right here, I've got a 1973 and a 1974 Ford Bronco. That drive. They're not done. This one has the chassis done and the engine done. This one has the body done. So obviously I have my priorities backwards because I could have made one whole Bronco by now. And so I'm super excited for the new Bronco to come out because I don't have to do anything to it. I can literally get in at the dealership, drive across the street to the front range and just go ballistic on it, and I don't have to do anything to it. And I'm super excited. But that vehicle is going to cost me well over 60 grand. But then we thought, hey, since we're putting that kind of money into a new Bronco, let's just take a round number of $55,000. We could actually buy an early Bronco that runs, drives, for the most part fully restored for that money instead of buying the new Bronco. What if you decided to take that $55,000 and invest it into an early Bronco instead of buying the new Bronco? Good, bad? There are both. We chopped it down into 10 different areas to do our best at balancing out what you get for your money with both. And this is what we came up with. Ha! Let's get into this. Our hypothetical number of 55,000, where did we come up with that? So 55,000 gets you a Wild Trek with most of the options. That's 55K. Okay, good. What does that buy you with an early Bronco? So oddly enough, I had picked this number out of the blue because I knew, because I own two Broncos. So we kind of know what they go for in a semi-restored condition. But just to make sure that I was doing this correctly, I went to Auto Tempest and I pulled all of the Broncos that are for sale right now in the United States that are listed on a major site, and I came up with 109 Broncos. Out of those 109 Broncos, 37 of them were early Broncos. Then I took the 37 Broncos and I split those into two categories, 81,000 and up and 80,000 down. I figure reasonably a Bronco with a brand new engine, a brand new transmission, especially upgraded with brand new running gear and everything, I can see someone asking an interior, 80 grand for that Bronco and probably getting it. But for the most of us, you use our Broncos, we drive them every day. We restore them to a point where they're super nice and people freak out about them, and they end up in people's like calendars and people rent them off for photographs and stuff. Those Broncos, there were 28 of those. Of that 28, the average price was $54,645. So, right at that $55,000 threshold. Oddly enough, the nine that were above 80,000, the average price was 107,000, with the highest price one being 170,000. So 55,000, I think, is reasonable. You either get a really highly optioned two-door Badlands, or you get a very well-restored driver early Bronco of really any year. Since most of us don't have $55,000 just sitting around waiting to put on a vehicle in cash, you're probably gonna have to finance this, at least some or all of the funds to get this vehicle, because it's a dream vehicle. In the new Ford Bronco, you can get that loan literally anywhere. You can get it on the internet, you can get it from your local bank, you can actually go to Ford and you can get Ford's financing. Now, those finance rates right now, with this video being made in February of 2021, I found rates from anywhere from 3.27 to 13.97 on new vehicles. But the average that I found, it would be somewhere in the fours, like maybe 4.5, something like that. The max loan you're gonna get for a vehicle like that likely is going to be 6 years. The standard is gonna be 5 years. Now, if you wanted to get a classic Bronco, you could actually get classic car financing through, for instance, Hagerty or JJ Best Bank. And I found rates on those from 2.99 to 7.99, with the average right around 4, a little bit below 4%. So in a lot of cases, you can actually get an early Bronco at a lower finance rate than you can a new Bronco, and they will finance those for 10 years or longer if that's something you wanted to do. And at a lower percent for a longer term, you're gonna get a very small payment. So if you're adding a classic Bronco to a already big car fleet, or like us, if you're gonna have a Bronco that you're gonna have a new Bronco and you want an old Bronco to go with it, that's two payments. One of those you can make really small by going with classic car financing. The value of the vehicles. So the value is even on day one, $55,000. So at this point, the new Bronco is going to go down in value, whereas the old Bronco is potentially going to go up in value. Although, looking at this graph from Hagerty, you can see the big major explosion in value for the Ford Bronco was between the 2010s up until about a couple of years ago, and now it's starting to flatten out a little bit. Now, it may take off again. The collector car market is very unstable from that. It can go up, it can go down, it can crash. And the addition of the new Bronco, right now, we don't know what's going to happen. That's a separate video that I'm gonna be going into, is my prediction of what's gonna happen to my classic Broncos when the new Bronco comes out. The new Bronco for the first year probably won't depreciate as much as you think it will. If you look at the Ford Raptor, and you look at the prices on the Ford Raptor actually retained a lot of its value. As time takes on, these early Broncos will start to depreciate more and more when the 2022s and 2023s come out, including the Warthog and the special editions like the Heritage come out. I believe that the new Broncos that come out in 2021 will depreciate a little bit more in value and will definitely be valued less than those newer vehicles. Insurance, obviously, is going to be a big factor in a 4x4 vehicle. New vehicles have a tendency to be very high insurance because they're very expensive to replace parts on. Whereas vintage vehicles, depending on the year, and we're just talking about Broncos right here, these early Broncos like the ones behind me are going to be less to repair in a very similar accident because there's significantly less technology in these. If I smash up this fender right here, I'm usually just smashing up that fender, maybe another piece of sheet metal. Whereas in the new vehicles, you have all kinds of sensors and wiring, and then likely airbags deploying. So the expense is significantly greater on a new one. So therefore you can expect insurance to be higher. And then if you look at the actual cost of the insurance, new vehicles like our new Ford Bronco will go off of actual cash value in case of total destruction. And ACV is replacement cost minus depreciation. So your $55,000 vehicle that may be a year old, that gets into a major collision and ends up being totaled, may only be worth $40,000 to the insurance company. And that's a pretty big issue. Now for classic car insurance is typically less expensive. And you also agree on a kind of what's considered to be a guaranteed value on the vehicle, so that if in case of an accident, you know, and the insurance company knows what the payout is going to be, and you can feel comfortable about the fact that if it does get totaled in an accident, that you're going to get the actual value that you would get when you sell your vehicle. Okay, warranties. This one's an easy one. New Bronco, 3 year, 36,000 mile bumper to bumper, and 5 year, 60,000 mile powertrain, which is a pretty standard, if not low to standard, warranty on a vehicle. Doesn't always cover everything that might happen to the vehicle. Whereas with your older Bronco, it has zero warranty unless you're buying it from a dealer that will give you a warranty on it, or if you can buy a classic car warranty, which there are some out there, which sometimes are worth it, sometimes are not. I think with a Bronco, they're probably not worth it unless you've got significant technology built into it. Like you've got a Coyote Mudder with a computer and, you know, other things in it that might actually be more expensive to replace. Then a warranty might be something you would look at. But typically when you're buying a Bronco, you get no warranty. You are out of pocket on every single thing that is going to happen to that vehicle, every part that needs to be fixed. But that goes into my next point. Aftermarket. Aftermarket is a big deal because right now on our new Bronco right here, there is no aftermarket. There will be, as soon as these start hitting the ground, there will be manufacturers that are going to be scrambling to get parts out, scrambling to get bumpers and fenders, replacement fenders, bash plates, and suspension upgrades, lighting upgrades, interior upgrades. Those will be coming very quickly, and probably within a year, you're gonna have a really good aftermarket. But on our classic Bronco, there's a huge aftermarket. You have Wild Horses, you have Tom's Bronco Parts, you have BC Broncos, Bronco Graveyard, James Duff, CJ Pony Parts. There is a huge aftermarket. You can literally do anything you ever would wanna do with these Broncos by going to one of these aftermarket manufacturers and dealers of Bronco parts. And you can literally build anything you want to. So you could actually buy one in the 20s, mid-20s, a good vehicle that doesn't require a lot of sheet metal, and you could spend $20,000 on that vehicle and make it the hit of a show. Whereas with our new Bronco, it's gonna look exactly like almost everybody else's Bronco out of the box. All right, let's talk about safety. Safety first. Not one of my mantras, but at the same time, because I drive old vehicles, but at the same time, I understand that safety is super important to a lot of people, especially when you've got your families riding around in them. So when we look at our friend, the new Bronco is filled to the brim with safety options. You have dual stage airbags that will inflate based off of how significant the crash is. You've got side air curtains, electronic driving aids, which may be the biggest thing because at that point it keeps you from getting into a collision, and advanced track with roll stability control. These are all big deals. Crumple zones, 3-point seat belts. You would have to get into a significant crash to get hurt in one of these vehicles. Now, our friend, the classic Bronco, it was not built for safety. It was built to be freaking cool. Well, yeah. I mean, they had safety in mind when they developed it. I mean, it was made of metal, you know, so it's like, it's hard. It had, you know, lap belts, you know, 2-point seat belts, you know, to keep you from flying out of the vehicle that has no roof or doors. I mean, come on. This was pre-1979 when car crash test actually became a thing. Car crash test didn't even take place until after the early Bronco was dead and gone. But on the other hand, if you look at it, it doesn't have airbags. It's got a metal dash. Most of the roll cages actually bolt straight into the body. And at best, the body is Swiss cheese in most of these things. So it's not built for safety. You don't buy this for safety. Although at 55 grand, which is our target point, they should probably have at least front disc brakes. They should have power assisted brakes. They should have 3-point seat belts, and they should have maybe even a family roll cage, which goes from front to back, which gives your family more protection in the case of a rollover. So really at our $55,000 target point, maybe you have more safety built in than you think. Drivability. Obviously the new Bronco is going to be a good driver. I think I've seen 1,000 tests so far where they drive it and they say it's like one of the greatest driving vehicles they've got. I'm going to make this relative because you can't very easily make an early Bronco drive like one of the new Broncos that's going to come out of the factory. The new Broncos drive like a new car. They have lots of driving aids to make the cars easier to drive with adaptable cruise control. And, you know, so they're not going to be equal from that standpoint. The new Bronco has the 7 GOAT modes. Sand, slippery, sport, eco, normal, mud and ruts, and rock crawl. Those are the GOAT modes, which is go over any terrain, and they're likely to change off-roading as we see it now, making it super easy for even the most novice of off-roaders to go out and enjoy the backcountry. Now, the early Bronco, it had GOAT modes as well. In fact, it was the original GOAT. That was the name of the Bronco project in 1966 from the start. It was the GOAT, the Go Over Any Terrain. And they had their own. But they only had four back then. That was first gear, or crawl mode, second gear, or grocery mode, third gear, or highway mode. Notice I didn't say interstate mode, which we'll go down in just a second. And then fourth was reverse or retreat mode. And you know what it did fine? It did fine for like 50 years. Didn't need, you know, electronic aids and stuff like that. You just learned how to drive. And that's just the way that it was. And if you got stuck or you rolled your Bronco, then, you know, that's called a lesson. Let's talk about the rarity of these vehicles, because at first, they're both going to be relatively rare. So for instance, the new Bronco, Ford is probably going to produce 70,000-ish of the new Bronco for 2021. The classic Broncos, or the early Broncos, those were produced 240,000 in the 12 years of the first run of the Bronco, and obviously a lot of those have been lost. So there's still over 100,000 of those vehicles, of these early Broncos, out there in the world, where there's only 70,000 of the new Bronco. Now, that stated, in 2022, the new Bronco is going to catch up, and there are 190,000 reservations right now, and that was as of a few months ago. So it could be well over 200,000 now. And next year, they're going to produce obviously more than they are this year, so it's likely to be at that 200,000 unit threshold by the end of next year, potentially. And then at that point, you'll be relatively even as far as the rarity of these vehicles. Now, obviously, over time, the new Bronco is going to well outpace the old Bronco. And as these old Broncos get crashed, smashed, jumped off cliffs, things like that, they're going to be more and more rare every day. And last but not least, cool factor. Old Broncos are cool. We know that. That's easy. New Broncos, I think theirs are going to be cool right off the bat. So one of the reasons why I wanted to get my new Bronco early is because it's going to be rare to see one on the road for a while. With 70,000-ish being produced this year, it's going to be seldom seen. So it'll be fun to drive around. Now, when they start producing them by the hundred of thousands at that point, they're probably going to be less cool. I look back at things like the FJ, when the FJ came out. The FJ came out, it was pretty cool. Now when you look at them, or I should say most people look at them, it's kind of an everyday common car. I don't see that and think back to the early FJs, but that's just me. Now on the other hand, the older Broncos, whether it be a first, second, third, fourth, or fifth gen, specifically the first and second gen for me, the cool factor is always going to be super high, and it's only going to go higher, I think, because there are going to be fewer and fewer of them out on the road. Obviously, the ones that are the most either original or the most modified are probably going to have the greatest amount of cool factor. So hopefully that was fun for you. I answered my own question, which is which one is cooler, and if I had 55,000, what would I do? And obviously I would buy both. So what would you do with 55,000? Would you buy a new one or an old one? Please put that down in the comments. Let me know what you think. There is a market for both, and your 55,000 goes a long way in both directions. Also, check out our website, mile3garage.com, where you can find Mandy's cool designs like our Fat Thor shirts and things like that. So click on that link down in the description and check out our website. It's kind of fun. We throw a lot of stuff on there. And she's got 10 new t-shirt designs that are totally original. You should check them out. They're a lot of fun. That's a wrap for Mile.3 Garage. We are building these two Broncos and awaiting our first edition that should be delivered hopefully in early part of June. So stick around, subscribe, and let's get building these things.